rectangle tool. Together with the ellipse or circle tool, one of the most used drawing tools in any vector software, so they got a nice little place of their own on the toolbar. Before we can show you how to draw and manipulate a rectangle, we first go to wireframe. There are several different options. You can select this button over here, or select view, quality, wireframe, or press shift F9, but the most easiest and direct one is just clicking this button over here and you're in wireframe. Select the rectangle tool, click anywhere on the worksheet, keep the mouse pressed, and just draw a rectangle. If you want to draw a square, press the Ctrl key while drawing, and you're drawing a perfect square. If you want to draw from the center of your mouse location, press Shift. And if you want to draw a square and from the center, press the Shift and Ctrl key, and you're drawing a square from the center. If you want to leave the rectangle tool, there are several ways of doing this. You could select another tool. Mostly you would select the selection tool. You can select previous tool from the context menu, or you can just press escape, which switches between the two last selected tools. Now we're gonna clean up the worksheet by removing every object on the page. Also several different ways of doing this. Click anywhere on the worksheet with the selection tool and start dragging a selection rectangle around the objects. Select, edit, select all, or press Ctrl E, a shortcut key. Or the most direct one is just, at least if you want to select all the objects on the worksheet, double click on the selection tool and everything gets selected and just press delete. Press escape again, you're now back in a rectangle tool, draw a rectangle, select the selection cursor or use escape. You can now manipulate this object in any other way you would any other object in EasySign. Just select it and drag it. Of course, when you are in color, you can select it anywhere you want. You could scale it by using one of the selection extents on the corner. You can distort it by using one of the selection extents on the sides of the object. And you can click it again. Then you get the rotation and skewing controls. Skewing, rotating, and if you rotate while pressing the Ctrl key, you limit the rotation steps to 15 degrees. Press delete, draw another one, and select the drag tool. You can also change width and height with the drag tool. Also, you can round the corners by dragging one of the corner points. And there is a great difference between distorting the object with the selection tool, excuse me, with the drag tool, or with the selection tool. We'll demonstrate this in a more clear fashion. We draw a rectangle, duplicate it by moving it downwards, pressing the Ctrl key so it gets constrained to either vertical or horizontal position or movement, excuse me. Press once on the right mouse button to leave a duplicate of the object. This one we're going to scale twice the width it is now. We can do this in several different ways, but the most easy one is to just press Ctrl when dragging one of the selection handles on the side. As you can see, it gets restricted to steps of 100% of the original width. We're going to make this one the same width as this one, but with the drag tool. Select the node on the side, drag it, and move your cursor to the node of the other object. This way they're now exactly the same size. As you can see in the bottom status bar. To demonstrate what's happened here is do another rectangle. If we move it, distort it to the right, nothing happens, but in EasySign you can move the cursor to another location and still dragging it, so you can snap on either this object, or on this location, whatever. And they are now all exactly the same width. So, why going to all this trouble? Simple. Select the bottom one, select the drag tool, round the corners. Perfectly rounded corners. Select the top one, round the corners. Oops. They're not so perfect. They are exactly in a scale from 2 to 1. Because we scaled or distorted the object with the selection tool. And if we make it the size it was original, now they are perfect corners. Press Ctrl Z to put it back, and you see you get a distortion. If you select the properties and change the type of corner, you can more clearly see the distortion that's happened here, while this one has no distortion at all. These are exactly the same length. Last bit, maybe went a little too fast. I called the properties of the object. You do this by selecting the object and keep your mouse cursor exactly above one of the lines and select properties. If you do this in color mode, it doesn't matter where you select the object or where you press the right mouse button, you always get the properties of the object. But working in wireframe is mostly the best option, because you can see more clearly what you're doing, especially when you get a situation like this, where starts one object and where ends the other. In wireframe you can see this. To resolve the problem of aiming exactly on one of the outlines of the object, you can just simply select the object and press this button over here, which calls up the properties of the selected object. And no matter if the object is distorted with the selection tool or with the drag tool, on any angle you can still adjust the properties. With the drag tool or change the type of corner to whatever corner you need for the piece you are working on right at that moment.